video is brought to you by Good Night.
And we're bringing this conversation to you, a very common scenario in most households.
Yeah.
What is it, girls?
Bedwetting.
It's just a conversation that has been running around for decades, hundreds of years, thousands of years, the beginning of time. I think we just need to talk about it. It's not that complicated.
And it shouldn't be awkward either.
Shouldn't be awkward. I had a wonderful conversation with Dr. Heather. She told me a little bit about why some people wet their beds and what's the cause. But I just think it's so important to just sit down with us and just have a conversation. And whatever you hear from us today, hopefully you learn a little bit. Mm-hmm. And tell us in the comments below what you think.
What do you guys think, girls?
Just being accepting about it. I feel like no kid should have to really be ashamed of it because it's normal. Everybody does it. I did it. I would have dreams about me having a dream where I wake up and I go to the bathroom, done it, I wake up and I'm like, oh no, I did it. I was ashamed like when I was a kid because I was just like, oh no. Because at my age, I felt like, oh no, I'm getting older and I shouldn't have to be peeing out of my bed. But I realized that shouldn't be the case because it's normal. She did it so many times growing up. I've had friends and like cousins before.
It can be overwhelming because if they're doing it every night, I know changing the sheets, it can give you more workload.
Yeah.
But I think it really, we have to think about the emotional changes that are going on in your child.
I had a sleepover with my best friend and we woke up in the morning and the bed was wet. And I was like, wait, did I pee myself? Did I do that? And I'm like, wait, but I'm not wet. And asked my friend, oh, it's okay. You accidentally pee yourself. It's okay. But she didn't want to admit it. She wanted to just keep it in. I knew she was keeping it
in. She felt embarrassed?
I can tell she felt so embarrassed. Like, it was awkward. And I'm like, no, it's okay. No, if you did pee, it's okay. Like, that happens to me a lot. I've had a dream sometimes. Where,
like Alexa?
Like
so
Alexa.
Weird.
It all starts with a dream.
It all starts with a dream. You know?
I think the key is to have communication with your family.
Yes.
Parents, if you're watching this, kids, if you're watching this, it is important to have communication. Mm-hmm. Parents, please don't be too hard on your kids. I know it can be troublesome. I know that it could be exhausting, especially if they do it every night, you know? Come on, in the comments below, how many of you have ever had an accident before? And that's why we're having this conversation.
It's so normal.
This conversation is more about, yeah, it's normal. It's we're trying to normalize it, to stop the shame.
No, and remember that when your child is growing, sometimes their bladder doesn't catch up. I read about it, that it can also be like a constipation issue or a growth. Or even if you as a parent experienced it, it can also have because of family history.
More than one reason for you not to pinpoint your son or daughter or pinpoint yourself. You can't continue to shame yourself.
Because but
pay attention to your body.
Because if you keep on just telling them, stop waiting in the bed, go to the bathroom after, it's going to make them feel like, it's not normal. It's not fine.
Like some people don't want to go to their sleepovers and have fun at a camp because they feel like if they pee themselves and they would be bullied and ashamed because then they'll be made fun of.
And you bring a good point, Alexa, because it's really important to make sure that the siblings are not making fun of the child.
Make the children feel like they're safe with their parents, that they can tell them these things.
Yeah.
And sometimes kids don't tell their parents that they pee themselves because they feel
they're
gonna get yelled at. Like, hey, why did you do this? Like, why are you peeing yourself? I clearly told you and I potty trained you. It's like, that makes the situation so much worse.
Don't forget to be part of this conversation in the comments below. What are your thoughts about what we shared? Tell us a little bit about maybe your experience, maybe something you know, maybe an idea, something that could help.
Sharing your own experience really helps because it helps the child understand that they're not alone. That you went through it and I went through it. I was always afraid of going to sleepovers because I had a couple accidents because I come from a very traumatic upbringing. It just really had to do with a lot of my insecurity and fears.
Yeah.
And I really did. I felt really ashamed.
Dude, and we're barely finding out about these things now as adults. Oh, that makes sense when we were kids. That's why we were doing that. And that's it, Reality Changers. I really hope that you enjoyed this conversation. Don't forget to leave a like to let us know you guys are here. Comment below and tell us what you thought about this video. And also, big shout out to Good Nights for sponsoring this video. And that's it. Have a wonderful day. Take care of each other and just communicate. That's all you have to do.
Yes.
Okay?
Mm-hmm. And have patience.
Have patience.
Be patient. Patience
matters. Respond in a loving manner. That's
and be careful with your words. Like, notice your words, okay? Because sometimes your words can be really hurtful.
Yeah. Yes. Have a wonderful day, everybody.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.